covenants array. Will you keep coming to church and praising God? Come on, when things aren't perfect in your life, will you begin to bless God anyhow? When hell may be breaking loose all around you, will you reverse the curse and say that I believe God that restoration and joy is coming my way? I believe God in the name of Jesus that you're not a man that you should lie. God, you said it, and that's good enough for me. Will you believe God when there's nothing else to stand on but the fact that God said it? Well, I come to tell you on today, if God said it, that settles it in my life, and I believe it. I come to tell you over your life, I believe there shall be the abundance of rain. Oh, someone better put their hands together and get happy about the move of God in your life. Amen. That's why rain falls. The Bible says that God rains on the just and the unjust. But the difference is some folk in their dry season can even speak to the atmosphere and say, I see the abundance of rain. Man, let me tell you, it was a drought during that time, Sister Loretta, for 3 years. There was no rain that came from anywhere. I'm talking about anything with any life existence was dying and decaying away. But at the word of the Lord, and then Elijah moved and said, I know it's been 3 years, but with no rain. I know that, amen, this drought and this season we've been in have been going on for a long time. But I speak and declare by faith that there shall be an abundance of an anointing. Amen. There shall be an abundant worship. That God will open up a storehouse and pour out a blessing that there shall not be room enough to receive it. God, we give you a shout of victory and triumph in this place on today. Oh, I'm not going to abide in a dry place for much longer. You're not going to stay in a dry place for much longer. But I believe we're going to walk past it by the faith of Elijah. He said that I'm tired of the dry season. He said, I'm going to speak it into it. So, my God, how did he speak it? We read now in verse 42. The Bible says, so Ahab went up. In other words, he believed the word of the man of God to eat and to drink. And Elijah went up to the top of Carmel, and he cast himself down upon the earth and put his face between his knees. In other words, he said, I believe the word of God. I spoke and declared that this is my season for the abundance. But God said that now you got to empty yourself out of everything that's unlike me for me to move upon the word. Yes, it is my word. Yes, I'm going to do just what I said I'm going to do. But I need you to empty yourself out. Get on your face, boy. Begin to pray and believe that what I say shall surely come to pass. So Elijah put his face down. He began to pray and seek God and say, God, I confess my sin before you. God, I believe that you're a righteous God and you shall not lie. God, I believe that you said it, you shall surely bring it to pass. I know God has been a drought in my life. God, I know the praise hasn't been what it should have been. The Holy Ghost is talking to me right now. I know the worship may not have been what it should. God, I know I have not had all the finances, your promise, and your word. God, I've been speaking it, but there's been something that I've been missing in the name of Jesus. But I declare, God, I hear the abundance of rain. God, I believe you want to saturate my land. God, you want to saturate everything around me and everything connected to me. God, I believe this dry season has come to an end. God, I believe you for power and praise. God, I believe you for blessings and abundance. God, I believe you for a move of God. God, I believe you that my children and my grandchildren shall be blessed. God, I believe that my wife and my husband, my brother, sister, and father shall be all you said it should be. Elijah, I believe what you said because God said it. I believe there's an abundance of rain even in the midst of a drought. My God, I'm preaching to myself right now. I know it's not what it should have been, people. But Elijah said, if we can speak a thing, it shall surely come to pass. But amen, he put his head down. He's praying and believing God, and nothing's happening. Verse 43 says, and he said to his servant, go up now, look toward the sea. And he went up, he looked up and said, there is nothing. And he said, go again 7 times. In other words, he went the first time, and there was no move of God taking place. There was no provision. There was no blessings. There was no joy. There was no power. He began to wonder, is God going to come through and do just what he said. His servant went the second time and came back with discouraging news. Has anybody ever prayed and believed God for something and it maybe didn't come to pass the first time or the second time? But the word of the Lord said on the day, you better keep on praying and hold on to God. Hallelujah. Unchanging hand. The servant went the third time and came back and said, Elijah, amen, your word has not come to pass. I'm looking around and I still see a drought. Elijah, I could believe in my sanctified imagination, said, whose report are you going to believe? Amen. He said, go and check a fourth time. He went out to the sea and said, amen, I don't see a move of God taking place yet. He said, Elijah, it's still a drought all around the land. Bills are still unpaid. Mm-hmm. Amen. They're still fighting in the home. Amen. The need has not been met according to God's riches and glory. Elijah kept his head down, kept on emptying himself out of anything that's unlike God. He said, to have something I never had, I know I got to believe God like I never believed him before. Yeah. Go a sixth time. The servant a sixth time. And came back. And you know, folk will discourage you sometimes. Yeah. This thing just may not happen. The enemy begins to talk to you. Yeah. It's never going to turn around. Yeah. It's not going to work out for your good. I think we might as well give up right here. Throw in the towel. Throw out the towel. There will not be a move of God. Let's just, amen, say God may have made a mistake. Amen. God's not going to move in this season. I know we heard rain, but maybe we heard incorrectly. You know how the enemy can get some time. You know how friends and family can get some time. Well, Elijah told him, amen, after the sixth time, he said that God has never failed me yet. I know what God's word declares. Go and check the seventh time. I can imagine a servant went discouraged. Amen. I know what he's saying. I know what God's supposed to do. But let me just go here and waste his time and my time and come back with a negative report. Well, the seventh time, I can imagine he went and I was already prepared to come back with bad news. Yeah. You know, sometimes, amen, the Bible says that God will not put more on you than you can bear. I can imagine a seventh time that Elijah would have probably lost his mind wondering if his prophetic word was accurate, wondering if there would be a latter rain in this season in his life. When the servant came back and had this praise report in verse 44, and it came to pass at the seventh time. Someone say the seventh time. Come on, look at your neighbor and say, God may not be there when you want it, but he's on time. On the brink of a breakdown, on the brink of losing his mind, on the brink of the whole nation turning topsy-turvy, on the midst of him probably walking away from the church and giving up the faith. I heard a preacher say one time that the enemy's last tool in a believer's life is isolation. He said when he can get you isolated, then he can come in to kill, steal, and destroy. When he can get husbands and wives separated from one another, when he can get parents and children separated from one another, when he can get the sheep and the shepherd separated from one another, and then his goal and his plan is to isolate you, but someone say the devil is a liar. Amen. He will not isolate nor defeat the people of God. We plead the blood over your life and claim in the name of Jesus that you shall in no wise be plucked out nor taken away by the fowler. Amen. It shall knock on your door, but shall not come nigh your dwelling. We speak and declare and decree, and it shall be. Well, my God. Amen. And if the Bible continues to say in verse 44, that he said, behold. Someone said, behold. There ariseth a little cloud out of the sea like a man's hand. In other words, the Bible says that God showed up, amen, just like he promised. He brought the abundance of rain. He brought the anointing. Amen. He brought rain to the land. Now the harvest came. The latter rain fell. And God's promise was fulfilled. People, I come to tell you that every promise of God in your life shall be yes and amen. Amen. God, amen, just didn't show up when we wanted him to, but he showed up when we needed him to in the point of our breakdown. Amen. I don't know about you, but there have been some times where I've been holding on and trusting God, but sometimes we get a little bit weary in well-doing. But thank God the Bible said that we shall reap if we faint not. Amen. I'm blessing God, amen, for the hope that making us not ashamed on today. You can't be ashamed and holding on to God's unchanging hand. You can't be ashamed and believing that God would do anything but fail. I need you to speak out of your mouth and say, I hear the abundance of rain.
I hear the abundance of rain.
You gotta speak it over yourself. I believe.